Hello, Teleosteros here, and I just found out just a little while ago that I got my 100th subscriber, and I think it was Agent Up One Up or Up One. I hope I got your name right. Well, anyway, thanks for everybody who actually subscribed. No contests or anything. I kind of have to be a cheap bastard about this. You know, financially, this past year has been brutal. Anyway, but I figured I'd also it's also 1 year. Next week will be like 1 year when I actually started doing my videos. And I kind of wanted to show, this weekend, because it was a snowy day, you know, we had a snowstorm, so I couldn't go shooting. And, but the forecast is pretty good for next week, because frankly, I got an itchy chicken finger and I gotta get that thing scratched. Haha. Anyway, I kind of want to show a little bit of the ammunition differences, though, because I'm finding out, I have talked sometimes people when they hear, like, a 50 caliber muzzleloader, they're thinking, oh my god, it's so big and everything like that, thinking, like, the 50 caliber BMG, and it's like, no, it's not that big. So, I figure also I'm going to do a comparison here, like, you know, this is the 22 long rifle, compared with a 7.62x54 R round. That's for my Mosins. And of course, this is for my trapdoor Springfield, the 4570 trapdoor. Now, 30 caliber, 31 caliber. Well, basically, this is a 31 caliber bullet if you think about it, but this is the 310 that I shoot out of my little squirrel rifle, which eventually you'll see a shooting video. I was going to think about doing a request for videos, but I'm like, you know what? I'm going to eventually make a video of everything. So it's like, why bother? You know? So, but you can obviously see, this is basically about the weight, same grain size as the 22 long rifle. Elongation really makes a big difference. You know, you go from 40 grains to 148 grains. On this one here, is a 440 round ball, and you can see how oxidized it is. That was kind of what I was mentioning in my shooting video with my Kentucky rifle. I kind of didn't really, it was kind of hidden by my hand, but that's just shows you how oxidized it was. With a 405 grain hollow based bullet, that's my most accurate round, because that was the Army round initially for the first trapdoors. See? Got. Oh, can't really see it properly, but hollow based, almost like a mini. And it kind of gives you an idea, you know, just how much is actually filled up with black powder. And you can see, obviously, big difference in size. This is a 405 grain bullet. I forgot how much this is, but this is under 200 grains. I know that. And then here, of course, is a 490 round ball, which I use for my 50 caliber. So it gives you an idea that, you know, 50 calibers are really not that big when it comes to muzzleloaders. Then the next thing I wanted to show in comparison is, of course, my mini ball that I shoot with my Parker Hale Enfield. 577 caliber round. This one is the most accurate of the bunch. This is the thick-skirted Lyman round. Really shoots accurate with this gun. And this is, of course, a round ball, a 562 round ball that I shoot with my 58 caliber wheel lock whenever I can get that thing running properly. Long story. That's probably going to be like the very last gun I ever do a shooting video on. Not for nothing. But I also shoot my, sometimes if I want to be cheap or I ran out of rounds, sometimes I actually did do round balls with my Enfield too. It uses the same round, so why not? Not quite as accurate as the mini balls, but it does work. And then just for comparison, I brought two of my musket balls. This one being a 690 round ball that I use with my 72 caliber muskets. And, of course, this is a round that I have not shot yet because the gun is still being made, although from John Buck said it's almost done. You know, he told me to call him again this upcoming Friday. This is for my big 8-bore musket, 83 caliber. This is an 80 caliber round ball, and if the weight was right, it should be a 768 grain bullet. And I am not kidding when I say a 768 grain ball. I mean, look at that. Can you say that's going to hurt you? That's actually what they needed to punch through the heavy armor of the late 1500s. So, well, that's it. I just wanted to show, do a little comparison, you know. This way you kind of get a, gives you a better perspective of these various rounds and just how big some of them really are. And in the case of the round balls with the muzzle loaders, the only way you can get a bigger grain bullet was to actually get bigger in bore size. You know, it wasn't like with these conicals where you can go, you know, short, you know, just change the length and get a lighter bullet. So, have a good one, and like I said, thanks for 100 subscribers, and talk to you next week. Hopefully, we'll have a shooting video up. Bye.